to your Thursday, we could see some of the fields like temperatures be as low as 50 below, and that is extremely dangerous. So just think about your pets as well as yourself, because it's living things that really feel that wind chill factor. Things like, for example, your car will see the temperature and say the fluids go down, so with the air temperatures, but it won't go below that. So notice the temperatures for today's highs, only 4 below in Bismarck, 22 for the air temperature in Minneapolis, Des Moines at 29, and that cold air is going to keep all of that snow on the ground for us, and in some cases, even some of that heavy snow on the ground as we move forward into the end of the week. So there's that clipper system. We can say goodbye to that. High pressure takes over for a little bit of time. That's also what's responsible for that cold air filtering in behind the front, and that's going to really push further down to the south as well. And you'll notice tonight's lows, 1 in Des Moines, 19 in Bismarck. So this is the air temperature factor in the wind that feels like it could be 30 to 40 below, and mainly where I showed you those alerts in place. But look at Dodge City, Kansas City. You'll be in the teens tonight. And then as we get into your Thursday forecast, we have moisture that's being pulled in from the south. And so we start to see a little bit more of that wintry mix and freezing rain spread out. So Kansas City, you might see snow first, but look what happens on the backside of that. We see some of that freezing rain move in. As your temperature starts right around freezing, that is going to allow for some ice accumulation in many spots. Then this spreads out across the region. Chicago, you're looking at that snow, and Detroit as well on Saturday. After the system moves through, it's much quiet behind it, but it's going to be those impacts that go into our forecast for your drive to and from work the next couple of days, and for your kids, maybe even having some school closures because of not just the temperature, but also because of the snow or because of the ice. Now, Davenport, you're going to get a break on Thursday, so there's some good news there. But Friday, Saturday, snow in the forecast, even some freezing rain mixed in. Those overnight lows will be in the single digits as we get into the beginning of the new week. In Milwaukee, we have a blast of cold air. We warm up just a little bit, but then as we start off the new work week, we'll see temperatures below average in the 20s and overnight temperatures in the single digits. Now, if you were hoping for a nicer forecast down in the south, Patrick, I don't know about that for many.
Yeah, it might not be the story here across the south central region, especially in the areas of west Texas, western Oklahoma, and across Kansas, where we've got some messy weather on the way. Now, Dallas, you had fog out there this morning, even some drizzle and mist, but we could even see a stray shower thunderstorm into areas of the Mississippi Valley and the Tennessee Valley today with a cold front moving through. We do have that risk of severe thunderstorms. Cities include like Chattanooga over towards Greenville, maybe even getting near Shreveport in northwestern Louisiana. There's the front that I mentioned. As that front starts to push through it, it's going to allow a lot of the colder air to really build in behind this front and move into a lot of these areas up into the plains of Kansas, into Colorado, into areas of New Mexico. But we are just going to see some scattered showers and thunderstorms through early on Tuesday morning, so Dallas might be waking up with not just fog, but you might even have some showers and thunderstorms to deal with to start your day, and just a line of intense rain, maybe over a lot of the same areas that are still recovering from the heavy rain from this previous rain event that moved through. But look at that changeover to the wintry weather in the areas of New Mexico, starting to spread over across the border into the Texas Panhandle. That's the wintry weather that's on the way. And as we're looking at our forecast, we're going to focus on ice accumulation. Look at that darker purple that we're seeing into Texas, into western Oklahoma. That's where we could see the best chance of ice accumulation or greater. So we're not looking at just a light glazing of ice or ice. This could be over a tenth of an inch, creating some very hazardous travel as well as the potential for power outages. Still very warm conditions, though, across the south central region today. Look at these temperatures. Dallas, you're going to be 20 degrees above normal. Not feeling like a typical January afternoon, but the cold air starts to move in tomorrow. Tulsa, you go from the upper 50s near 60 to 43 tomorrow. Little Rock near 70 today. Not even getting into the 50s for tomorrow. And New Orleans along the coast, you'll stay a bit cooler tomorrow, but it's still not too bad for you there at 73 degrees. There's the cold air tonight, Lubbock, 32 degrees. So that's the big question. Are we going to need to get close enough to freezing to get that changeover to the wintry precipitation? And we think that will be the case because Lubbock, you're only going to be into the mid-30s for highs. Oklahoma City, 37. So just very close to that wintry precipitation mark there at the surface as far as freezing rain. So maybe coming down as rain and then freezing on contact. And that's why we are expecting at least some ice accumulation in these areas. So we're going to continue to watch this. We'll keep you updated. Even the potential for some heavy rain. Don't go anywhere. We've got more Weather Nation coming up. We also want